Good morning. So in the last class, we have seen on what are the different grades of concrete and nominal mix concretes. Okay. So now we shall go to the next chapter. Okay. It is design philosophies. Now we will be directly peeping into the our syllabus actually. Okay. Because now this is all important with respect to our examination. Okay. See now, in a sense now, if I ask you a question like, what exactly the design is? What do you understand by design? Or, if I design something, okay, it should fulfill few things. What exactly it should fulfill? See now, if I design anything, okay, first is, it should be safe. Say for example, I want to design an aircraft. I want to design an aircraft. The first prerequisite is it should be safe. Whenever it is flying, it should be safe. Okay. Then next characteristic is it should fulfill its intended purpose. In a sense, it should do its duty. That is the second important thing. Okay. I design an aircraft. If it doesn't fly, I don't say that it's a proper design because it is not serving its purpose. It is not at all flying, so I don't call it as a design. So the second characteristic is of any design is it should serve its purpose or it should fulfill its intended purpose. And the last one is the last characteristic is it should be economic. Economical means now, I should not spend a lot of money on that. Okay, it should be as economic as possible. So sir, if your design incorporates all these things, okay, then only I will call it as a scientific design. Otherwise, we don't call it as a design. Say for example, I want to design a building. The first thing is, it should be safe. In the sense, your building should not collapse. Safety is the most important thing, okay. The first prerequisite is the same. It should not collapse under any circumstances. Second thing is now, it should serve its intended purpose. And the last one is now, it should be as economic as possible. Okay, so this is when we fulfill all these things, then only I say that I have done a good design. Otherwise, no. Okay, so now, when I come to our RCC, okay, there are three different design philosophies. The first one is working stress method, or it's also called WSM. Another one is ultimate load method, it's called UWM. And another one is limit state method, it's called LSM. And these three are the different design philosophies. Okay? By using any one of these methods, I can design my RCC structures. Okay, so now in the older days, working stress method was very very popular. It was very very popular when the RCC came into existence. Okay, almost all the RCC structures they were built or they were designed by using something called working stress method. Okay, then slowly, okay, as an improvement, ultimate load method came into existence. And at last, we are now landing on this limit state method. So now, what exactly these three are? Briefly, we will try to know. See now. First of all, I will take up this working stress method now. So what exactly this will try to know? See now, in your previous class, I will say to that, if I want a beam, something like this, assume that it is a simply supported beam, okay? Then in the tension zone, I am going to reinforce the concrete. Okay, in sense, I am going to put the steel here. Steel is embedded in the tension zone of our concrete. Okay, wherever tension zone is there I am going to reinforce the concrete by using the steel rods. So now, here I have drawn a cross section. In the sense, see this beam from this end. You take a cut here now. Okay? C
see the beam from this end. Okay, you will see its cross section. Am I right now? See, you are going to see the breadth of the beam, B, and you are going to see the overall depth of the beam, capital D, and you are going to see these steel as rods, dots. Okay, maybe three rods, maybe there in this beam, three rods, maybe there. So I have shown the cross-sectional area of the steel here. And this cross-sectional area, I will call it as AST.
AST means it is the area of steel, cross-sectional area of the steel.
And this small d indicates it is up to the center of this steel. From this to this, I will call it as the effective depth d. It's called effective depth, small d. This is my neutral axis, okay? This neutral axis depth from the compression fiber is called N, and automatically this becomes D minus N. Okay? So this is a small explanation regarding the cross-section of this beam. Okay? So now, what exactly this working stress method says? Let us try to see now. See now, suppose when I start loading this beam, like this, the beam tries to now bend. Like this. Okay, tensile stresses are here, compressive stresses are there at the top. Compressive stresses and tensile stresses. And now, if I draw the stress distribution diagram, it will be something like this. Stress distribution diagram will be something like this. Your topmost compression fiber here, in the sense, it will reach the maximum compressive stress. Am I right? The next fiber, if I take, it is stressed less. If I take the next fiber, it is again stressed less. If I take this fiber, it is again stressed less. Here, less, less, less. At local axis, you will see that the stress is zero. Then, if I take the steel here now, the steel has undergone the maximum tensile stress. Okay, stress again decreases, and it reaches zero at the neutral axis. Okay, this is how the stress diagram looks for a RCC section. Okay, I hope you have understood this. See now, in the event of this, okay, if I don't allow this concrete stress to exceed the permissible compressive stress in concrete, okay, sigma CBC, it is called permissible compressive stress in the bending in the concrete. Okay, if this concrete stress do not exceed the permissible limit, okay, then I say that it has reached the stress of permissible stress. Similarly, the steel also, I will not allow the steel to be stressed beyond its elastic limit, sigma ST. In a sense, this steel is also stressed under the elastic limit, or it is stressed to its permissible tensile stress, sigma ST. Sigma ST means it is the permissible tensile stress. Sigma CBC means it is the permissible compressive stress in concrete in bending. Okay, so in this working stress method, what we do is now, I don't allow the concrete and the steel to be stressed beyond their permissible limits. If I adopt this design, then I say that I am designing my RCC structure by using working stress method. Okay, so this is overall picture of something called working stress method. So now we assume here that concrete and this steel, okay, both are elastic materials and they obey Hooke's law. Okay, this is all about, if at all a short note is asked in the examination, you should be able to write this figure and you should be able to write some points on this working stress method. Okay, so I will take up my next this thing in my next class. Okay, thank you very much.